whatsoever in the home.
Championship wrestling at ringside. This is Vince McMahon along with the legendary Bruno Sammartino. And are we expecting excitement this week? To join us will be the Junkyard Dog.
Who's that, Vince?
The Junkyard Dog.
My God, the Junkyard Dog. Here's one of the most lovable guys in wrestling today.
Also, to join us will be the tag team combination that recently in a non-title match defeated Adonis and Murdoch, that of Jack and Jerry, the brother team of the Briscoes. Another tag team match we see Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo join forces and face the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkov. And we'll find out more about this big mountain man in Piper's Pit.
Hey, I'm really thrilled about that he's going to be in Piper's Pit, because now we're going to have a chance to find out about this mountain man, because for week after week after week, we're all so curious. Now we're all going to find out something.
And also, Cyndi Lauper will be here by way of videotape. Let's go to the ring.
This contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from Jim Thorpe, Pennsylvania, weighing 252 pounds, A.J. Petrucci. And his opponent, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 280 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Listen to these fans. Are they ever behind the Junkyard Dog? Feel that electricity, Bruno.
Well, you sure do. This guy really knows how to electrify the people. And look at Carabella. He took off. He doesn't want anything to do with the Junkyard.
Step into the ring, A.J. Petrucci. A.J., an up-and-coming wrestler who has quite a lot of skills, and the Junkyard Dog appears to really be ready to lock up with A.J. Rather unusual, unique style on the part of the Junkyard Dog.
Different style. He certainly confuses an opponent, but I'll tell you, he is a big, impressive-looking, rugged guy.
The area of Pleasantville, New Jersey will be pleasantly aware that on Friday, the 28th of December, at the Egg Harbor Township High School Gym, the Egg Harbor Township Band Boosters bring World Wrestling Federation action to their town. And Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, a muscular sight to behold, is going to headline the all-star card at the Egg Harbor Township High School on the 28th of December.
AJ outside, the dog is doing his thing.
We saw a little bit of his speed there, Vince. When Petrucci went to hip toss Junkyard, Junkyard pulled a quick reversal, which you have to move pretty quick to do that. And he took him right over in a beautiful hip lock.
Dog now patiently awaiting A.J. Petrucci to lock up out in the middle of the ring. And here they go again. Side headlock down by A.J. Ooh, more than a side headlock. I think he hurt his hand. Now, there are a few knots up there on the forehead of the Junkyard Dog. He literally has taken his lumps through the years. A lot of calcium deposits up there. Oh, my, forget about it.
You know, not only that, but he's used a lot of headbutts. And when you do so many headbutts, you actually do build calcium. Whoa.
Oh, look at that. What a clothesline. This capacity crowd coming alive as they can do behind the likes of the Junkyard Dog. And the doghouse snaps it back to the camera. Cover by the Junkyard Dog. You'll get two, and that's about all. Dog now putting all of his weight out on A.J. Petrucci. As Petrucci is reaching for a handful of hair, the dog's going to show him how it's done. Junkyard Dog. A.J. Petrucci back on his feet, has him in the corner now. Winds him up, sends him to the far side. Look out, here comes the dog right at him. Shoulder blocking, down he goes. Junkyard Dog on top. We get one, two, and a three count. And yes, indeed, as the Junkyard Dog gets the Duke, we'll get the official time.
Here is your winner, the Junkyard Dog.
Junkyard Dog gets quite a round of applause. And let's take you back to what we saw earlier on. Oh, let's stay with this. A dog gets a bone. J.Y.D., the Junkyard Dog, brings this crowd alive. And yes, you can bet that they're behind him all the way. What's he doing now? Oh, my goodness. And like I said before, the dog can bring everybody to their feet. The Junkyard Dog with another victory chalked under his belt. Let's go back down, Bruno.
Well, here we see, well, this is after he whipped him through the corner. He caught him with a forearm. Down went to Jay, and there he goes, pinned him. He gave him a devastating blow.
Junkyard Dog, victorious, and we're just about ready now, ladies and gentlemen, to take you to a World Wrestling Federation update, the subject of which will be Jesse the Body Ventura. Let's take you now to the update.
The subject of our update this week is Jesse the Body Ventura. Jesse is never at a loss for words, and it would appear he's never at a loss for choice of startling, unusual, and bizarre ring attire. Of course, that is not even mentioning the coloring of Jesse's hair. Let us look at Jesse as he enters the ring wearing some of this bizarre get-up that he does wear.
This contest, scheduled for one fall, 30-minute time limit, about to enter the ring from San Diego, California, weighing 271 pounds, Jesse the Body Ventura.
Jesse, of course, does believe in excellent physical conditioning, as we saw there. A current wrestling magazine depicts Jesse at his other favorite sport, playing golf. However, I don't think his golf strokes are as good as his strategies in the ring. Jesse is also a very successful wrestler. Be sure you go and see him if he appears within your viewing distance. He is an exciting and sensational man to watch.
The all-new official WWF calendar is available now, and it comes alive with full-color portraits of your favorite Titans of the Ring, the legendary Bruno Sammartino and Son David, Andre the Giant, the incomparable Sergeant Slaughter, Junkyard Dog. And who's meaner than a Junkyard Dog? Well, maybe Mean Gene Okerlund, the Tonga Kid. And is she a movie star? Well, she could be, but really, it's WWF Women's Champion Wendy Richter. Also feature in full color, Ivan Putski, Tito Santana, the Ugandan Giant Kamala, Rowdy Roddy Piper, and all the Tuesday Night Titans. Don't delay. Order your official WWF calendar for $85 now. To order, send check or money order for only $9.95 to official WWF calendar, Post Office Box 6789, Stamford, Connecticut 06904. To order COD, call toll-free 1-800-221-7393. Visa and MasterCard accepted. That toll-free number once again, 1-800-221-7393.
Hi-ho, are you? We're in Piper's Pit, and I can't believe it. I'm sitting here with the greatest wrestling manager of all time, Captain Lou Albano. And, Captain, I ain't never had nobody make no phone calls. What you doing, man? Who you talking to? The president? What you doing? Ooh, I can't hear you.
I'm running with the Worldwide Wrestling Federation Action Hotline. Listening right here, talking about Roddy Piper.
Who?
They're talking about Captain Lou Albano. They're talking about the Samoans.
Wait a second. What's the number? What's the number? Let me call the number.
A special holiday issue of the official WWF magazine is now on sale. Take a behind-the-scenes look at Cyndi Lauper's victory party. See the many faces of Wendy Richter. A great cover story on Sergeant Slaughter. David Letterman flips over everyone's favorite magazine. Hulk Hogan and Gene Okerlund, the dynamic duo exposed. And Brutus Beefcake. Is he what every lady is looking for? Bruno Sammartino, a living legend, returns to wrestling, and Junkyard Dog takes a look at his past and present career. A special holiday edition of the official WWF magazine on sale now.
With me now, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Louis Albano, and of course, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Nice to have us, huh?
As you gentlemen know, Cyndi Lauper is going to be honored in Madison Square Garden for her contributions to the World Wrestling Federation. If we may, we'd like to take you now, ladies and gentlemen, to Houston. The Summit, a sold-out audience listening to Cyndi Lauper. Let's go to the tape.
I got myself a second career. Now, a lot of people said to me, Cyndi, what about acting? And I said, no, I know, I'll be a wrestling manager. And that's exactly what happened. You see, I have an undefeated record, and my girl, Wendy Richter, is the undefeated champ. That's right. So I just want to say hello to Wendy. If all you want to say hello to Wendy Richter. All right, fine.
No doubt Miss Lauper, a goodwill ambassador every place she goes, be it Houston or anywhere in the world indeed, which is one of the reasons why she, of course, will be honored in Madison Square Garden. I, for one, cannot think of a more deserving individual to be honored. I'm sure that you would agree with that, Mr. Piper.
Deserving individual? You know, if it wasn't for myself and Piper's Pit, you see, I got tired of smelling beer on the broad's breath. I got tired of having the babysitter, and I know you've got other clips, and I donated a lot of time to some undeserving wench that all of a sudden figured she got big shot and wanted to go away, and now you want to give her an achievement award. I want you to see something else she's done, because she's such a big shot.
She is a big shot, deservedly so. Let's take you to the Los Angeles Forum, ladies and gentlemen. And Cyndi will be managing Wendy Richter in a match that took place with the Fabulous Moolah. Let's go to the tape.
Hope she lost.
Wendy Richter is the reigning World Wrestling Federation Women's Champ. The 24-year-old native of Dallas, Texas, has been competing in the ring for 4 years, but recently acquired a new manager.
I want to thank her from the bottom of my heart for helping me win this belt, because I couldn't have done it without her.
You're talented. You're a talented athlete. You're an Olympic wrestler. And that's where your strength is, and you're a marvelous athlete to watch in the ring.
Rock star slash wrestling manager Cyndi Lauper draws a comparison between the two.
Rock is a lot like wrestling. I guess that's why I'm her manager, because it's very physical, and I have to work out to do what I do.
Tonight, the team of Wendy and Cyndi put their belt on the line against women's wrestling legend, the Fabulous Moolah.
If she gets in trouble, she'll cheat any way she can. Her manager's the same way. You know, I guess they give each other tips. And I won't trust her out there.
She has to watch out for a few things, some of the ways that Moolah might trick her and get her into the corner and start ripping out her hair.
In a glamour event like this, the stars come out.
I like your jewelry.
Yeah, I like your style, too. I like your voice. I like your singing.
Things were looking bleak for Wendy as the fabulous Moolah got the pin. But then, in an unprecedented move, the match was suddenly restarted, and miraculously, Wendy pinned the Moolah to retain her belt. A storybook finish, but that's the wrestling biz.
Notwithstanding, Mr. Piper, that you apparently do not think that Miss Lauper is deserving of this award, surely, Lou Albano, you have to agree that
she doesn't. Let me tell you something. You're looking at a man who controls his women. You're looking at Hot Rod, and what you're going to do is the only time that Cyndi Lauper has ever peaked is when she was on Piper's Pit. If there's anybody that is deserving of an award in Madison Square Garden, it is Hot Rod himself, not Cyndi Lauper, not anybody else. It's me, Mama.
Thank you, Mr. Piper. Let's take you now to a special interview.
It's your pleasure.
Get ready, Philadelphia. The World Wrestling Federation coming to town at the Spectrum here in the great city of brotherly love, Saturday, January the 12th, first big card of 1985. Luckily enough, Rowdy Roddy Piper, you and your bodyguard, Cowboy Bob Orton, are going to be part of this great card, going against the Tonga Kid and Jimmy Superfly Snuka. By the way, where is Bob Orton?
Your bodyguard. Ace is taking some time off. Ace is going to come to the city of brotherly love. You see, if it's the city of brotherly love and Tonga and Jimmy Snuka and everybody's into brotherly love, that's fine with me. Myself, I kind of into women. Now, that don't bother me one way or the other if that's the way you want to be. If that's what Snuka wants to do and Tonga wants to do, they want to stand in each other's corner, they want to hug each other, they want to kiss each other, they want to wear skirts. If that's what they want to do, that's
hey,
fine
skirt.
With me, hot, hot. It's fine with you too, isn't it? You see, if the Tonga Kid wants to watch Snuka's back, Snuka wants to watch the Tonga Kid's back, they all want to get in the ring at the same time. I found a way to accommodate them. I went and got my bodyguard, Ace. I told Ace, come on down, Ace, to Philadelphia, city of brotherly love. Told him, come on down, Philadelphia, if you want to get in the ring and get it all done, I'm up to here with BG and I'm up to here with Toe Jam in their feet. I'm up to here with Big Fat Lips. I'm up to here with people saying Roddy Piper's a coward. I ain't never been afraid of nothing in my life. You can believe that. Just look at me. I am all man. See, brotherly love, that's exactly what we'll have. You guys are going to be able to love each other forever and ever and ever while you're pushing off little tiny daisies.
It will be Rowdy Roddy Piper, Cowboy Bob Orton, meeting the...
Bubba, I'm going to tell you something that you like better than football.
Tag team match, scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first to my left, from Blackwell, Oklahoma, at a total combined weight of 461 pounds, Jack and Jerry Briscoe. Their opponents, from Marion, Ohio, weighing 245 pounds, Charlie Fulton. His partner from New York City, weighing 239 pounds, the unpredictable Johnny Rods.
Johnny Rods and Charlie Fulton, comprising quite a tag team combination, squaring off against the Briscoe brothers, and Jack and Jerry Briscoe, as many of you will recall, recently defeating Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch in a special non-title matchup. There's that big old mountain man again, Bruno. He's here every time.
Every week, I'll tell you.
And I'll tell you, certainly looking forward to that Piper's Pit. We can find out a little bit more about the big mountain man.
I certainly am.
Clean break on the part of Jack Briscoe, backing off.
We at the World Wrestling Federation wish well the efforts of the Egg Harbor Township High School Band Boosters as they bring the mat sport to the Egg Harbor Township High School gym in Pleasantville on the 28th of December in that southern New Jersey town. You're going to see on the bill four outstanding lady wrestlers, the Spoiler, Nikolai Volkoff, and more at the Egg Harbor Township High School in New Jersey on December 28th.
It seems so.
Jack Briscoe, both Jack and Jerry, former collegiate wrestling champions and have held so many different regional championships through the years. Look at this. Oh, my. Takedown. Jack individually, of course, former NWA champion. These fellows have really, I don't know anyone else in pro wrestling that have really accomplished quite as much as they have.
Well, for one thing, Vince, they've been working as a team for many, many years. They know each other so well. They're brothers. And they are so quick, so scientific. They can rough it. They can do anything. And I don't know of any tag teams, personally, that are really better than the Briscoes.
They got out, but they surprised the effort of Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch very recently in that non-title matchup.
Well, they looked very impressive that night as they wound up with a double figure four leg lock. And, of course, they made both those guys submit. Interesting to see them get a title shot to see if they could repeat that.
Johnny Rodz taking over now on Jack Briscoe and Charlie Fulton tagging in. Charlie Fulton now against there, Brutus Beefcake. Why is he out? Ooh, my, with an elbow. Quick cover, we have one. Oh, that's about all. Quick tag is made now to Gerald. Jerry Briscoe. Backing Charlie Fulton the rope. Looking to the far side and up. Nice shot by Gerald Briscoe. Cover, he could get him. Nope. Charlie Fulton off the rope. Nice shoulder block. I think unimpressed is Brutus Beefcake. Look at that maneuver. Wow. Yes, indeed, the Briscoes, who win so many of their matches with the brain power, notwithstanding sizable amount of brawn as well. Let's get the official time.
Here are your winners, Jack and Jerry Briscoe.
Jack and Jerry Briscoe, victorious. What a fine brother tag team combination this is, and as Bruno Sammartino stated, when they have their title opportunity, should that happen, we could have new champions. You could be looking at them right there. Let's go to the replay. And there is a good look at Brutus Beefcake. Although that's not exactly what we really wanted to see. That's what we wanted to see, Bruno.
Look at this, the way he scissored them over here. He scissored one leg, hooked the other one, and he just couldn't move, and he pinned them.
Yes, indeed. Jack and Jerry Briscoe victorious over Johnny Rodz and Charlie Fulton, notwithstanding the distraction of Brutus Beefcake, who's certainly more than just a distraction. Brutus Beefcake really leaving a mark for himself thus far throughout the World Wrestling Federation.
Fans throughout the Delaware Valley, get ready in Philadelphia at the Spectrum Saturday night, January the 12th. Another great World Wrestling Federation presentation. A couple of tag team bouts I've got to talk about. Tag team champions Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch will be defending against Jack and Jerry Briscoe. Many fans by now know that the Briscoes defeated the champions in a non-title bout in front of a national television audience. Another tag team bout that I am going to be watching very closely indeed. Pitts, if you will, Rowdy Roddy Piper and his personal bodyguard, tag team partner, Cowboy Bob Orton, against my guests at this time. The Polynesian connection, if you will.
The guest that you got that I just like to tell the people in the spec room that it's going to be like this, brother. It's going to be pandemonium. Because Piper, the last time we were there, brother, I was outside the ring. And you were inside. Your bodyguard was outside the ring because he came and attacked me. And that's how I know. And the people know that. And my cousin here, brother, we are so psyched. We are so mentally and physically down in one feeling, brother. We are going to stick together like we always been. You started it. You did it. And you didn't finish it.
You didn't finish it, brother.
This family's heavy, baby.
You had to bring your bodyguards with you.
We never believe. We might take you, brother, and put you down on that mat. You take your other bodyguard and bring him along, brother, because we're going to grind, brother. You know what grind means?
So hard,
when you get this Polynesian soul,
Milo, I lose
down deep, brother, we're going to get down with it. And believe me, brother, you have got the South Pacific connection in bubbling. Just like a volcano erupting, brother. And that volcano erupts, you know what's coming out of it.
Sorry, we're out of time. Stay tuned. I'm excited for that.
Satisfied yet. I don't think, oh, here comes the suplex, by the way. This is going to be a vertical suplex.
Valentine in complete control of Aldo Moreno. Oh, my. Elbow into the lower abdomen area. Was not low enough to be a foul. The referee right there.
Well, what he's doing, Vince, he's punishing Aldo Moreno right now. With those devastating elbows, these suplexes. Look at this. Now he's going to drop right on his knee. And at the end, he's going to wind up, you watch, with a figure four leg lock.
Well, that was a hold that took him to the championship. And there. Yes, you can hear the fans chanting Tito. I think that's only serving to raise the ire of one Greg Valentine. Aldo Moreno whipped through the ropes and outside. Nasty fall out there. And Valentine looking down. Out there somewhere, probably, no doubt, will be Lou Albano. There's the captain on the far side. Interestingly enough, earlier on, it appeared as though Lou Albano differed somewhat with the opinion of Roddy Piper earlier on concerning the merit of Cyndi Lauper.
I got the impression he was a bit turned off. Look at this slap from outside. Boom, right in there.
Greg Valentine now. Thus far, this match has been lopsided, which is not what we expected. Now, Valentine going down, sinking down. He's going to get the figure four leg lock. Yes, he does. Cinch it in real well now. Aldo Moreno. And that's all she wrote, as Mr. Moreno quickly submitting to the very punishing, painful hold. And, Bruno, you've had that leg lock applied on several occasions. You, of course, have used it on several occasions. That's a devastating hold.
Most devastating. When applied properly, I don't think anybody can get out of it. And Valentine applies it properly.
Yes, the master of the figure four leg lock.
Here is your winner, the Intercontinental Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Greg the Hammer Valentine, victorious, as we'll take you back now to what we... Yes, there's an Intercontinental Champion. Chip Belt is... Valentine, another kiss on it. Let's take you back here now. Aldo Moreno comes in the hard way.
There he slams him from outside, brings him in. Look at this. He had already been working this guy over pretty bad. Now he takes the leg. Watch, I think he's going to give it a couple hard blows. Not even. It just went right into the figure four leg lock. And, of course, once applied, nobody applies like Greg Valentine. Moreno had no choice but to give up.
All right, well, let's go now to Rowdy Roddy Piper standing by in Piper's Pit.
All the time, somebody always wants to be a big shot. We have last time there was some guy, some hillbilly, who's sitting out there who wanted to get a chance to be on Piper's Pit, and me being the man that I am, wherever you are, somebody draw him a map, help him on up here. Let's bring the hillbilly all the way up and give him the absolute thrill of his life by being on my pit. This here's my bodyguard. His name's Ace. He's my friend. So draw him a map. Excuse me, you have a seen eye dog for him. Oh, there he comes, my. Well, oh, y'all come on down now. My, oh, y'all come in. There. Can you play the banjo? What's your name there, son?
My name's Big Jim.
Big Jim. Well, he's a fair-sized boy. You're a fair-sized boy. Where are you from?
I'm from Kentucky.
Wait a second. Kentucky. Excuse me. Turnip. A little few turnips there. Like you fell off the turnip truck. Just kidding, Big Jim. When you come up here to Piper's Pit, it's kind of
It's kind of a tradition to take your hat off, man. Would you take your hat off, boy, please? I mean, just a little respect.
Huh? All right.
That's it, Big Jim. Why don't you have yourself a seat here right in front of Ace? Don't you listen? You know, a guy like you, big, strong fellow like you, could probably... Have you ever wrestled any? You ever tussled any?
Well, I've wrestled a little bit around the house. That's about all. Out back a little.
Out back, you've wrestled. You look like a big old fella. You know, if someone like myself was to take you and manage you, possibly I could make something out of you instead of the Pierre Cardin you are now, man. Why don't you let somebody like me take you and give you a chance? Look at what I've done for everybody. Go ahead and let someone like me give you a chance. After all, who's better for the job, man?
I don't know, Mr. Piper.
Wait a second. What don't you know? I know decisions are hard for you. What's the problem, man?
I don't know. I don't know if I want to do that.
Why?
I just have to think about it. I don't know.
You have to think about it. Who are you going to ask? Certainly you're not going to ask any of your relatives, man. Who are you going to ask?
I just like to get the best person available, you know.
Well, I'm the best person.
I don't know, sir.
You don't know. You know, stand up for a second. Stand up, Big Jim. You are big. Why don't you go, just if you were just to take it a step further and you were to think of everybody you could think of, you couldn't think of anybody more able than me, and you have nobody to go to ask who would be more able, I'll tell you what I'll do myself. I'll take you, give you $200-$300 a week, I'll make you start.
I don't know. I'll have to ask the people. I don't know. I'll just ask them what they think.
Well, you go ahead and brush off them. That's fine, Big Jim. You go ahead, because if you got to ask them people and you want to look like that all your life as compared to this, you didn't have as much on the ball as I thought. And I didn't think you had a lot going anyway. You're going to hang on to this.
Now you can get rid of your
and
baggage.
And I can't believe it. I'm sitting here with the greatest wrestling manager of all time, Captain Lou Albano. And, Captain, I ain't never had nobody make no phone calls. What you doing, man? Who you talking to? The president? What you doing? Ooh, I can't hear you.
Roddy with the Worldwide Wrestling Federation Action Hotline. Listening right here, talking about Roddy Piper.
Who?
They're talking about Captain Lou Albano. They're talking about the Samoans.
Wait a second. What's the number? Let me call the number.
With a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first to my right, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 248 pounds, R.T. Reynolds. His opponent, from Tocula, Mexico, weighing 244 pounds, Tito Santana.
Is some extraordinary athlete right there, Tito Santana. Yes, there's another look at him. Mr. Santana, former Intercontinental Champion, getting ready to lock up with R.T. Reynolds as they do in the middle of the ring.
You know, Vince, I was talking to Santana earlier. He told me that he's been really working hard on a hold. He wouldn't indulge on what the hold is, but he says, just watch, he says, because the opportunity comes, I'm going to display it, I'm going to shock everybody. I'm really curious, and I hope he does get the opportunity to show it, because for Santana to be that serious and that secretive about it must really be something special.
Well, right now, Santana taking over on R.T. Reynolds off the rope, and downstairs goes Tito. Big lift, my goodness. Santana working on the arm bar, and Tito taking over on R.T. Reynolds. That would be most interesting. Santana, of course, a master of many holds.
True.
And if he has developed another one, if he has that opportunity, we certainly would like to see him. Look at that shoulder block. Off the rope, over R.T. Reynolds, coming right back at him now. Oh, nice reversal. Arm drag takedown. Santana with a back body drop. R.T. is just... he doesn't know what is happening to him.
I think Vince Santana, since he's been back, since he started again after that knee injury and surgery and what have you, I think he looks more fired up. I don't know, as great as he always has been, he even looks even more so right now.
Well, everyone, of course, trying to pick out a weak spot on Santana, wondering if, in fact, the knee surgery was 100% successful. obviously, from what we can see, it definitely was 100% successful.
No doubt about it. He's just great. His technique's given him no problems at all.
Santana in control of things over R.T. Reynolds at the moment. Mr. Reynolds, an experienced wrestler who certainly knows the ropes. This will be a tremendous win for R.T. Reynolds as he comes back up into standing position and rakes the face now, I believe, yes. Elbow follow through. And this capacity crowd trying to bring Mr. Santana alive. He's ripped to the buckle. Here comes R.T. missing to the knee. Santana working on the leg. Santana driving R.T. Reynolds now over to the corner. What's he doing? You think that's what he was referring to, Bruno?
I doubt it. What's this?
Santana!
Look at this!
There's a figure four leg lock if I ever saw one!
And that's what he was referring to, the figure four leg lock. I'll be doggone. Look at this.
Santana applying the figure four leg lock. And earlier on, if you will recall, on this broadcast, we saw another figure four leg lock applied. That one by Greg the Hammer Valentine. And this one by Tito Santana. I must say, Santana's leg lock looked every bit as impressive from where we stood as compared to
Valentine. Here's our winner, Tito Santana.
Tito Santana, victorious. Let's take a little closer look now at the figure four leg lock application.
And look at this, here he is, he applies it perfectly. Now watch, as he goes down, he hooks it with his own leg. He should bring that leg down, let's see. And there it is, and look at the pain on Reynolds. I mean, he is in pain. That's why he kept it such a secret, the figure four leg lock, I'll be darned.
No more secret now, Santana letting it out of the bag. He has perfected yet another hold, the figure four leg lock. Standing by now, ladies and gentlemen, from beautiful Hawaii, Don Morocco.
And now from the beauty spot of the world, the magnificent Morocco.
Isn't this ridiculous? New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, California, Oregon. Girls, come here. How can you snuggle with lovely things like this with all those lousy clothes on? This is magnificence.
If you're as busy as I am, Jiffy Lube Complete is a real lifesaver. In just 10 minutes, with no appointment, Jiffy Lube changes my oil, installs a new oil filter, lubricates my chassis, checks and fills my vital under-the-hood fluids, and much more. A complete 14-point service at one low price that's hard to believe. And all in less time than...
Time, allow me to introduce the manager, the Hollywood Fashion Plate Classy, Fred Lassie. This tag team match is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, first from Russia, weighing 313 pounds, Nikolai Volkov. And his partner from Tehran, Iran, at 258 pounds, the Iron Sheik. Their opponent, from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 240 pounds, Barry Windham. And from Syracuse, New York, 238 pounds, Mike Rotundo. Ladies and gentlemen, Nikolai Volkov insists that you all rise and respect his singing of his country's anthem.
Too much.
much respect showed to Nikolai Volkov. Look out from behind. Here we go. Volkov. And the Iron Sheik hammering away. Watch out. Windermen Rotundo now. But no. Nice reversal. Up goes the Sheik. Dropkick. Nikolai Volkov outside. By the Iron Sheik outside. Pandemonium has broken loose. And these two youngsters have really electrified this capacity crowd.
The Sheik and the Russian, they Pearl Harbor, Windham and Rotundo, but these guys are just showing what they're made out of because they came back in a fall of fire.
Barry Windham, Mike Rotundo, an extraordinary tag team combination. And it did not look good for them just moments ago when from behind, as Bruno brought out, Volkov and the Iron Sheik began the attack. But now, facing head to head now, it's going to be the Iron Sheik to start off things with Mike Rotundo. Sheik circling about, locking up now, going behind, nice maneuver, nice reversal. Over, look at the takedown by the Iron Sheik. Sheik now, off the rope, at the elbow, and listen. Rotundo scoops up the Iron Sheik, what a body slam. Tag is made, from Sweetwater, Texas, Barry Windham with a forearm. Windham now in the rope, and a shove to the rope, off he goes, oh, the Iron Sheik. Pinch him around. Windham gets behind him. Has him up. And the big Russian now. That's a monster at 317 pounds. Nikolai Volkov.
Windham is out slugging him. Let's look at this.
Volkov trying to power his way through the match. Oh, missing with a roundhouse slap. But no. Look at that. Drop kick, knocked him down. Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo holding their own, maybe doing more than holding their own. Shoulder block, the big powerful Russian pulls him over. Another one, no, Andrade takedown there. Massive Volkov backing Barry Windham to the corner, not the place to be with a big man like Volkov. Pushing with the right, on target, Barry Windham. Another one. Windham now trying to set him up. Coming off the rope. No. Windham with more damage to the back now, thanks to Volkov. Up, oh, no. Nikolai reaching over, tagging the Iron Sheik. The Sheik now on Barry Windham. Whips it to the rope, sets him up, back body, go. Try to make a tag and done. Drop kick, what a drop kick that was. Rotundo shuts him up. The Iron Sheik now to the ropes. Mike Rotundo has him up. Airplane score. Drops him down. Rotundo covers. He get one.
Oh, no.
Windham. Being ushered back, trying to make a tag. Yes, legally he does now. And they keep the Iron Sheik in there. What a match. Oh, look out. Here comes the Bulldog. Yes. Cover. One. Oh, Volkov. Wait a minute. Volkov. It looked like Volkov intentionally struck the referee.
I think he may have done that on purpose because it looked like the Sheik was going to be counted out, Vince, and he didn't want to get beat on a pin, and this way it's an automatic disqualification. There it is.
What an upset! What a fabulous match! What an upset! Unbelievable!
The winners of this bout, as a result of a disqualification, the team of Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo.
Unbelievable. unbelievable victory for these two who have really electrified this capacity crowd. Let's take you now to an interview. Here we go.
All right, fans, Philadelphia Spectrum, Saturday night, January the 12th, the World Wrestling Federation is going to be back in town. What a card. It is going to be tag team champions Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch going against Jack and Jerry Briscoe in a non-title bout in front of a national television audience. It was the Briscoes with the double figure four on Adonis and Murdoch who beat the tag team champions. Now those belts are going to be on the line. David San Martino with Bruno San Martino in his corner to meet Mr. Wonderful. Paul Orndorff with Bobby Heenan in his corner. And gentlemen, if I could prevail upon you, Bobby Heenan, you're going to be in the corner of Mr. Wonderful. Paul Orndorff, I'm sorry you just dropped your scissors. And why would you bring those out?
Just to remind everybody what happened to the Giant, anybody else that steps in the way of the Bobby Heenan family.
You can face our television cameras.
Yeah. You know, I remember how I used to talk every time I'd show my robe or show my body how the divorce rate would go up?
Turn around and face
Well, something camera. Worse has even happened. Something worse than that.
What Do now?
You, the television stations, the radio stations. Headline, warning, do not turn your TV sets on when you know Mr. Wonderful's on your TV set. Do you know that actually the women would turn their TV sets on and see my body and actually would pass out in front of their TV because Mr. Wonderful was there showing his body a little bit?
I didn't realize this.
The women cannot stand it because I am so good looking. That's exactly what it is. You know what? Bruno San Martino. What's his name, David?
David, right.
You know what I've always said, and it's true. You can't take Lassie and make Ren 10 10 out of me. That's exactly what his old man's trying to do. His old man ain't man enough to step in the ring with Mr. Wonderful. So what does he do?
He takes
his little kid, and he pushes him out to the ring, and he's wanting to make a name for himself.
Old man?
Well, nobody makes a name for himself at my expense.
Now, I'm a licensed manager.
Right.
I manage the best in professional wrestling. Bruno has no right to be in the corner of his kid. But this goes back a long, long time.
Wait a minute.
You see, I'm speaking.
Wait a minute.
I'm speaking.
You're not a licensed barber. So, I mean, what's the point? What are you trying to say?
Who are you to argue with my manager? Huh?
You want to be fired? I can do that like that.
Look, you little 8-5-er. Keep your mouth shut.
Thank you, Paul. Now, this goes back for years. David would always come home from school. Go get his old man, said they beat me up again. They worked me over. Bruno put on the big overcoat and go outside, and there it was. 12 Girl Scouts. They worked him over again. Bruno always have to defend his kid. Well, if he thinks he's going to help him get a victory over this man, you're badly mistaken, piece of face, because it's not going to happen. You get out of that chair one time, San Martino. You make one move towards me, I'll hit you so hard, I'll change your area code. And this man right here is going to do a number on your punk kid.
You know something else? You know the other day I've been going to different cities, and do you know that actually I'd go to cross the street, and do you know that the traffic would literally stop? The traffic would stop. And everybody would look at Mr. Wonderful and saying, I can't believe my eyes. I am seeing what I am seeing. There was actually traffic jams of people wanting to see Mr. Wonderful.
You know, the other day in Beverly Hills, I took him shopping on Rodeo Drive.
Sorry, gentlemen.
They wanted to have a parade for the man.
They
wanted to close the town.
Don't miss it.
Tag team matchup, Barry Windham and Mike Rotunda really proving themselves, no doubt of that. Speaking of tag teams, next week, ladies and gentlemen, a special holiday edition in which we will see the tag team combination of Superfly Jimmy Snuka and the Tonga Kid as tag team partner. That should be exciting.
Hey, when you put these two guys together, how could you ask for any more excitement?
Also, yet another tag team match. Next week, we'll see Ken Patera join forces with the monstrous giant in his own right, Big John Studd. Also, ladies and gentlemen, next week, a special Christmas story from Captain Louis Albano. That should be most interesting. And then a highlight of it all, yes, a special video from Cyndi Lauper as courtesy of MTV. In addition to which, ladies and gentlemen, to join us will be the likes of Mr. USA, Tony Atlas, Dr. D, David Schultz, David Bruno Sammartino, along with, in Piper's Pit, Playboy Buddy Rose. All of that and a whole lot more. We look forward to you joining us next week for a very special holiday edition of Championship Wrestling.
Ladies
and gentlemen, at this time we are going to take...